North County Cat Hospital, we recommend feeding cats diets that are composed primarily of animal proteins. I'd like to explain some of the physiologic reasons for that. Keep in mind that the topic of cat nutrition is controversial. There are a lot of experts who would argue that wheat gluten or corn or cranberries are healthy ingredients for cats' foods. We really don't feel, though, that the scientific evidence supports this. I think that part of the controversy is due to the lack of any large-scale studies looking at the long-term benefits of various diets in cats. No one has ever compared, for example, a group of cats eating mostly dry kibble versus a group of cats eating mostly canned food versus a group of cats eating raw food over a period of years to see which group had better health and fewer diseases. Those studies haven't been done. But we do have a lot of scientific information concerning the physiology of cats, and we do make recommendations based on that information as well as on our own experience. We know that cats are obligate carnivores. They need animal proteins to survive. They are adapted to the consumption of animal proteins and can't get all of their essential amino acids from plant proteins. There is overwhelming evidence that cats need a lot of protein, and there is a lot of evidence that carbohydrates are problematic for cats. Cats don't have the same digestive and metabolic pathways that omnivores, such as dogs and humans, have that allow them to benefit from plant-based diets. For example, carbohydrates lower a cat's basal metabolic rate. Cats need fewer calories and are less active when they are fed high carbohydrate diets. This has been shown in studies. If you feed cats carbohydrates, they slow down. Also, carbohydrates don't sate cats. When cats eat carbohydrates, there is no trigger to tell them to stop eating. They stay hungry. Additionally, cats use protein for energy. If they don't get enough protein in their diet, they use the protein from their own muscle for energy. Even if a cat is loaded up with carbohydrates, they burn protein for energy. Give a cat mostly carbohydrates and they slow down, they stay hungry, they get fat, and they lose muscle mass. We see this a lot, where a cat will suddenly be changed from canned to dry food, and they turn into these big slugs who constantly beg for food. So our general recommendation for most cats is to feed them a diet that is high in animal-based proteins and low in carbohydrates. This means canned food or homemade diet with limited or no carbohydrates. By the way, we don't usually recommend raw foods, in part because there are no good controlled studies to support a raw food diet, but mostly because of human health concerns. And those concerns are real. If your cat gets salmonella, they may be able to give it to you. You'll hear this low carbohydrate diet in cats being referred to as the Catkins diet. This is cute, but it is misleading. The Atkins diet is feeding limited carbohydrates to omnivores, to humans, who are adapted to eating carbohydrates. Cats are carnivores. They are not adapted to eating carbohydrates. And the metabolic response in cats being fed a low carbohydrate diet is radically different than the metabolic response to humans being fed a low carbohydrate diet. Cats are carnivores. Their natural diet is very low in carbohydrates. They have zero nutritional requirement for carbohydrates. So what about things that come from plants other than carbohydrates? When you look at cat food labels, you'll see things such as carrots or flaxseed or cranberries. All things that are coming from plants that are healthy in people, but there is no evidence that they're superfoods for cats. Cats can't readily convert beta-carotene into vitamin A. If you want vitamin A, eat a carrot or a sweet potato. If you want your cat to have vitamin A, giving them a carrot or a sweet potato isn't going to work. Now, to be fair, if you see beta-carotene listed as an ingredient in cat food, it may have benefit as an antioxidant, but not as a pre-vitamin. Flaxseed contains alpha-linolenic acid. This is an omega-3 fatty acid. Omnivores can convert this into the omega-3 fatty acids EPA and DHA. These are what are found in fish oil. Cats can't do that conversion. If you feed them flaxseed oil, it's just fat. And that's okay, but in a cat, it's not the equivalent of fish oil. Cranberries have never been shown to offer any benefit to cats regarding the health of their urinary tract. Even though it will say on the cat food label that cranberries are put in for urinary tract health, there is no evidence that they do anything other than give the food a cranberry flavor. And they may actually be harmful. They may predispose cats to kidney stones. There are a lot of other examples. Just because the label says that it contains something that would be good for a human doesn't mean that it's good for your cat. So the bottom line is that cats are little meat-eating machines. They are carnivores who are adapted to eating animals and not to eating plants. If you're thinking of converting your cat from dry food to canned food, please keep in mind that there are risks associated with changing cat diets. It is important to discuss this change with a veterinarian. Thank you for listening. If you want more details, we have other videos with a lot more information.